कटेंगे तो कटेंगे, एक रहेंगे तो नेक रहेंगे।
अगर वो कह रहे कि बटो नहीं कटो नहीं, तो पीढ़ी परिवार भी तो नहीं बटेगा।
थोड़ी दूर
ना तो बटेगा ना कटेगा, और चलेगा बाद में किसी भी।
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. After the tempestuous storm of batenge to katenge, now there is a pitenge twist that's coming. With elections around the corner, rajniti of faith and factions are fast changing the arithmetics of poll calculus from Kerala to Uttar Pradesh and Maharashtra. What sparked off this war of words? Well, interestingly, this caste versus communal cauldron was stirred with the center reportedly all set to conduct the census in 2025. Of course, everyone is waiting for the census cycle to begin. But what has irked the opposition is that sources have said that caste census is not likely to be part of the overall population census that may take place next year. Instead, the center is likely to count general quota, OBC, religion, caste, and sect-based census. With Uttar Pradesh bipoles around the corner, posters reminding electorates of Chief Minister Yogi Adityanath's "Batenge to Katenge" war cry was splashed across the state. This bid for Hindu consolidation seems to have spooked the India Alliance. Akhilesh's Samajwadi Party, which banks on the PDA, the Pichra, Dalit and Alpsankhyak, has put up posters saying "Na batenge, na katenge," an assertion that Pichra, Dalit and Alpsankhyak will unite for Akhilesh Yadav. Going one step further, Akhilesh's chacha, Shivpal Yadav, as you just heard, says "Na batenge, na katenge, jo aisi baat karenge, wo baad mein pitenge." Akhilesh's alliance partners quickly closed ranks to train their guns at the BJP for allegedly trying to divide and rule, while the BJP has claimed that anarchist appeasement of the opposition is out in the open.
वैसे तो शिवपाल जी समाजवादी पार्टी के वरिष्ठ नेता हैं, लेकिन जो उनका बयान है वो जो उनकी पार्टी की जो वर्तमान समाजवादी पार्टी है, जिसको जनता जनार्दन अराजकतावादी पार्टी के नाम पर जानती है, ठीक उसी तरह की का बयान उन्होंने दिया है। क्योंकि जो लोग अराजकता का समर्थन करते हैं वही लोग इस तरह की भाषा बोल सकते हैं।
जो बांट रहे हैं वही ये भाषण दे रहे हैं, तो बोलिए बांटना बंद कर दीजिए, काट बांट छाट बंद हो जाएगी। दिस इज अ स्टेटमेंट कमिंग फ्रॉम अ पार्टी विच हैज फेल्ड इन इट्स गवर्नेंस मॉडल।
But why is the entire poll arithmetic being done along the lines of Hindu votes and the PDA? Let's tell you on the NewsHour fact check. In the UP Lok Sabha elections 2024, the India Alliance led by the Samajwadi Party got 50% of the Pichra votes, 40% of the Dalit votes and 90% of the Alpsankhyak or Muslim votes. Compare these numbers to what the NDA's vote share was. It got only 45% of the Pichra vote, 26% of the Dalit vote and 2% of the Muslim votes, clearly leaving it behind in Uttar Pradesh, something that came to sting it in the final numbers. This explains why the Samajwadi Party is banking on PDA, which has been their winning formula in the Lok Sabha elections. Now, let's tell you why the BJP is eyeing the Hindu votes and wants to keep the Hindus consolidated. In 2024 Lok Sabha elections, the India Alliance got 28.8% of the consolidated Hindu votes, while NDA managed to get 50.6% of the vote share. Is this why Akhilesh and company are so worried when Yogi Adityanath and Prime Minister Modi both warn their electorate, "Batenge to katenge"? So, ladies and gentlemen, the legitimate question we are asking on the NewsHour tonight, "Batenge, katenge, Has that narrative spooked the India Alliance? That's the question and that's the debate coming up on the other side.
You're watching the News Hour at 9. Debate number 1 on Times Now. Super Prime Time.
Joining the debate tonight, Shehzad Poonawala, national spokesperson of the BJP, Dr. Anand Ranganathan, author, Rohit Agarwal, spokesperson of the RLD. Also joining me on the debate tonight, Sanjay Jha, author, Congress leader, also Vivek Srivastav on the show. But my first question goes to Vivek Silas, national spokesperson of the Samajwadi Party. Or Vivek Silas, why are you so scared of this cuttinge, buttinge? August 26th is when Akhilesh Yadav when Yogi Adityanath made this statement. Since then, you're not being able to get over it. Roz aapko ye yaad aata hai. Aaj Shivpal Yadav ji ko pitna bhi yaad aa gaya. Aap peetenge kya aap BJP ko? Vote se peetenge, waise peetenge. Why has this become such a central point in the elections, not just for the 9 bipoles that are happening in Uttar Pradesh? This is even echoing in Maharashtra, where posters have come up. Has the India Alliance somehow got scared that their PDA is shaky and therefore they have to go after buttenge to cuttenge?
I think the statement that has been made by Yogi Adityanath ji is quite dangerous for the society, because somewhere down the line it divides the society massively. Batenge to katenge, shamshan, kabristan, 80, 20, Eid, Diwali, Mangal Sutra, Bhans, iske siwa kya hai? You can see what Girijaj Singh is doing in Bihar, you can see what Hemanta Biswa Sarma is doing in Jharkhand, it's all the same thing. And that is the policy of the Bharatiya Janata Party, just to win elections, just to divide and polarize the society, which the Samajwadi Party and the India Alliance is not going to let it happen, you know. We saw it in, as you said, we are seeing it in Maharashtra, we saw it in Haryana as well. So such type of statements are not good for the Indian democracy. आप किसको बांटने की बात कर रहे हैं? पहले आप ये तो बताइए, कौन बटेगा तो कटेगा? और फिर काटने की क्यों बात करते हैं आप? कौन कटने जा रहा है भाई? That is the question which the people of India and the people of India are not going to like such statements. Because in 2024, if we see the Honorable Prime Minister, the way he was trying to polarize the votes by his statements, as I just told you earlier, what happened at the end of the day in Uttar Pradesh, especially Samajwadi Party bounced back and the India Alliance won 43 seats and Bharatiya Janata Party was hugely dented. So such type of statements are not good for the country and not good for the democracy. That is why we are defending it.
Well, Shehzad Poonawala, divisive BJP, is that your only formula by resorting back to the Hindu vote bank?
I'll show you some statements which are very uniting statements and which are good for the country, which are not dangerous. Ram Mandir Pran Pratishtha is Nach Gana, Devta is not Bhagwan, Hindu is Hinsak, Mandir goes molest women, Hindu terror, Hindutva is ISIS, 2611 was done by Hindus, Dwarka is Natak, Krishnaji taught Jihad to Arjun, Hindu is a dirty word, Hindu Dharm Dhoka, Sanatan Samap, Sanatan Bimari, Ram Mandir, Latkana, Atkana, Bhatkana because it is a Gulami ki Nishani, Kaha Paida Hue Ram, Ram Mandir Bekar, Ram Charit Manas is poison. These are all the statements which are creating unity and mohabbat. And what is being said by Yogi Adityanath ji or Sarsang Chalak ji is dividing the country when he says ki united we stand, divided we fall. Of course, they don't speak the chaste English like Shashi Tharoor and Anand Ranganathan. Therefore, Mr. Vivek Silas will judge them because they were saffron. Now, my question is, see, Bade Chacha, Ram Gopal ji, he said C word for CGI. And Chote Chacha has come down to his Sanskriti, which is Pitai, Pitna Pitai. I just want to ask two questions. वोट जिहाद जब होता है तब तो पुरस्कृत करना है, बांटो मत बोलो तो पिटाई करनी है. हिंदुओं को जाति और भाषा में बांटना है तब तो पुरस्कृत करना है, एक रहो कह दिया किसी ने, एक संत ने, तो उनकी पिटाई करनी है. हिंदुओं की जाति पर लगातार बोलना है और पीडीए पीडीए करना है, और मुस्लिमों की जाति पर तो एकदम कुंडी लगाकर बैठना है, तब जो कोई बोल दे, कोई पसमांदा बोल दे, तो उसकी पिटाई करनी है. और मैं आखिरी चीज केवल इतना कहना चाहता हूं कि देखिए, अब तो इन्होंने 9 सीट जो क्लियर किया ना नाविका, सुनिए बीजेपी की 9 सीट, 1 यादव, 1 कुर्मी, 1 पाल, 1 निषाद, 1 मौर्य, 1 वाल्मीकि, 2 ब्राह्मण, 1 राजपूत. और सपा का सुनिए, 4 मुस्लिम, 1 यादव, 1 कुर्मी, 1 बिंद एंड 2 दलित. इसी से पता चलता है कि किसको इनको जोड़ना है और किसको इनको बांटना है.
But let me get in Sanjay Jha. Sanjay Jha, my question to you is, why is Akhilesh Yadav's statement yesterday where he said, PDA na batega na katega, that's secular, but if Yogi Adityanath says, batenge to katenge, becomes communal. I want to ask you, they're exactly the same words that are stated, the same phrases that are used. Why is the propriety ownership of the term secularism the sole ownership of the India Alliance parties? Why is the BJP being called communal for using the same words?
Well, Navika, good evening. Who started using these terms? The UP chief minister did. Who further gave it a boost? Prime Minister Narendra Modi. So it's very clear and categorical as to the communal agenda of the BJP, which is, by the way, now known to every citizen of India in different, shall we say, quantums. Here is the bottom. You heard the BJP spokesperson, my friend Poonawalla, just now. He rattled off the jat, the religion, and the caste of each and every candidate right now on your show, which is further evidence of the very vicious religious and casteist politics of the BJP. But I'm not going to take too long. I'm just going to give you two examples. He gave many examples. I would give him one, which was spoken in the sacrosanct halls of Parliament. Probably, if anybody has heard it, the words cannot be repeated. The most vitriolic, venomous speech made by a member of Parliament against the entire Muslim community of India on the floor of the new Parliament, Mr. Ramesh Bidhodi. And we all know that the Prime Minister had nothing to say about it. So here is the truth, Navika. Whether you take, you know, genocide calls, Giriraj Singh's speech, the lynching violence, the BJP's playbook is just one thing, Hindutva, which means I have no problem. I'm a Hindu. Please celebrate our great religion of Hinduism if you truly are a Hindu. But you don't have to do that by beating other people or trying to, you know, kind of demonize others. I think the BJP's political business model stands exposed for India. It should learn its lessons from Uttar Pradesh. In Maharashtra, it could discover the lessons in a couple of weeks.
Well, Sanjay Jha, you know, I'll come back to you, Shehzad, but Sanjay Jha, you just forgot. You said he's speaking the name of caste, he's speaking the name of religions, he's so divisive. अरे भाई जिसकी जितनी संख्या भारी उसकी उतनी हिस्सेदारी ये किसका नारा है राहुल गांधी का एंड हु वांट्स द कास्ट सेंसस इफ इट इज डिवाइसिव इट इज एक्चुअली बीइंग डिजायर्ड बाय पार्टीज ऑफ द इंडिया अलायंस लेड बाय द कांग्रेस पार्टी एंड द ग्रेट आइडिया इज ऑफ राहुल गांधी सो हु आर यू कॉलिंग नेम्स हियर संजय झा लेट मी गेट इन आनंद रंगनाथन ओके ओके शहजाद हैज वन काउंटर एंड आनंद आई एम कमिंग टू
Because Mr. Sanjay Jha accused my party of doing vicious politics. Last time, Navika, I was not on that debate, but I was watching Anand and you, and Anand brought out a very important fact. Muslims' voting rights should be scrapped, says Sanjay Raut and Shiv Sena. Now I want to ask Mr. Sanjay Jha, is this vicious? Is this bad against Muslims? If yes, then what are you doing in the lap of Sanjay, not physically, just metaphorically in the lap of Sanjay Raut?
Let me answer your question. Navika, you raised a point about Rahul Gandhi's statement on Haq, etc. The caste survey is not talking about one caste versus the other. It's talking about the social and economic backwardness of around 85% of Indians that needs a voice and representation. That is very different from the parochial and the vulgar. And
so you want the caste census for what? For sitting in a bhajan, in a kirtan, or for creating that jobs, caste competitiveness. You know, Anand Ranganathan, ye caste census lekar kya karenge? Geet gayenge, bhajan gayenge, kya karenge? Uske baad lekar caste ke beech mein competition, kyunki keh hi rahe hain, jiski jitni sankhya bhari, uski utne hissedari. Jahan hissedari pe aayenge, is it not divisive?
Of course it is, Navika. Good evening. But can I please, through you, congratulate our good friend, Dr. Sanjay Jha, because first time in 5 years, you did not introduce him as suspended congressman. So I think good news is on the anvil, if I'm not taken. He's been unsuspended.
Well, you know, he's been taken in on my show. So I like to, acknowledge that. Because Pawan Kheda said that everything is all right between them. So
that is good news. I'm happy. Navika, as far as the topic is concerned, there are two issues out. The first one is, can I set the context right for the statement that was made by Yogi Aditya? It wasn't just made snatched out of thin air. He said it specifically in the context of the genocide that is currently going on against Jews in Bangladesh.
So his statement was very much in that context. Batenge to katenge, aap dekh rahe hain kya ho raha hai. Bangladesh mein even said that. That has been extrapolated to the situation of Hindus in India. Now, these are completely two different things. But before I come to that, I want to ask you, is it true or is it not? That's the nub of the issue. And it is true. Because who is to blame for this? And my good friend Vivek Ji is sitting here, both are good friends on either side, Vivek Srivastav and Vivek Silas Ji. Ek communist hai aur dusre pata nahi kya hai, abhi pata chal jayega. Lekin galti kiski hai? Isme sabse badi galti hai in logon ki jo ki appeasement ki bullet train chala chuke hain. Situation yahan tak pahunch chuki hai ki you remember in Karnataka when Congress won, the Waqf chief said, we demand two deputy chief ministers who are Muslim. We demand five cabinet works because it is because of us Muslims that Congress has won. You remember what happened in Hubli police station when it was run over by AIMIM led and 12 policemen were seriously injured. The cases against them were taken away. So, agar batenge nahi, to katenge problem hai, kat rahe hai. Because the moment these Muslim appeasing parties win, they take appeasement to such insane level. There are hundreds of examples. Let me give you the third example, which is really scary. The Supreme Court denied bail to 52 Coimbatore bombers. Then 58 innocents were killed. DMK let them off, defying the Supreme Court. And what was the pretext on letting them off? That let no one say that we are against minority. This was their pretext, Navika. Can you imagine? So they have taken the sign to such an extreme that the BJP and others have no option but to say, look, if we are not united, if you do not vote for us, you are going to see the scenario that you are seeing in Congress one state, which is exactly true.
Well, let me get in Vivek Srivastav. Vivek Srivastav, aap kahein to music, aap kahein to raag, lekin if anybody in the BJP says this, there is a problem. Is it okay to say katenge batenge to fir pitenge bhi? Is that all right? Akhilesh Yadav says PDA na batega na katega, that becomes secular, but BJP says it becomes communal. And what are we talking about? What are we talking about? We are talking about elections. If you and Abu Azmi of the Samajwadi Party stands there and says that if there are 8 Muslims who stand up and we have that number in the Maharashtra Assembly, nobody will be able to touch us. But that's not communal. That's not communal. No, that and he says, main apne kaum ke liye khada hota hu. That's not communal. But if Yogi says about his community, there is a problem. Yes. It becomes communal.
Yes, yes. You can't compare Yogi with Abu Azmi because Abu Azmi is representing the minority community, jiski sankhya bahut choti hai, and minorities in every country are vulnerable. Indian minorities in Canada and America are also vulnerable.
Why?
Blacks in America are
Hindus
also vulnerable.
Are children of a lesser God?
Crime hoti hai.
Are Hindus children of a lesser God?
Why? Crime hi nahi hoti.
Abu Azmi can say it, but Yogi can't. Why? Please explain to me why.
No, I have told you sociologically in any nation across the world, including United States and Canada, whatever be the nationality, if you are in minorities, aapke khilaf hate crimes zyada hoti hai. Minorities zyada vulnerable hai, hamesha, har mulk mein. आप पूछिए किसी सोशियोलॉजी के प्रोफेसर से।
पर आप जानते हैं ना, रिप्रेजेंटेशन ऑफ पीपल्स एक्ट डिसअलाउज एनीबॉडी टू आस्क फॉर वोट्स इन द नेम ऑफ रिलीजन।
एब्सोल्युटली।
सो
देन, बट ही
इज अबू आज़मी राइट और रॉन्ग?
या नो, इन द प्रेजेंट कॉन्टेक्स्ट, जब यहाँ बैठ करके डॉक्टर आनंद रंगनाथन कहते हैं साहब कि मुसलमान आ जाएंगे तो एक सैलाब आ जाएगा और हिंदू सर्वाइव ही नहीं करेगा। आई मीन, मुसलमान आपकी भीख के लिए नहीं वेट कर रहे डॉक्टर रंगनाथन। ही इज एन इक्वल सिटीजन ऑफ दिस नेशन, वेरी मच इक्वल टू यू, एंड नोबडी इंक्लूडिंग मी हैज अ राइट टू गिव हिम समथिंग इन भिक्षा। वो एक इक्वल सिटीजन है और कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन उसको और मुझको एक बराबर मानता है।
नहीं नहीं तो ये किसने Nobody has said that a Muslim citizen is not equal to a Hindu citizen. Have you said that, Anand Ranganathan?
Navika, please.
Why Bangladesh and India? Why are we comparing them? We are different nations.
Navika, no, sir, no. Vivek, what is going on here? Vivek, can you please allow me to speak?
Okay, all right. Anand is rebutting you, Anand.
Navika, please, he cannot just do this dog whistling. You must put a through you cork in his orifice. He just keeps on saying statements that I've never made. Number one. Number two, he says minorities all around the world are prosecuted and persecuted. I want to ask you, Vivek, are Dalits a minority in India, yes or no?
Yes, that is why we are going for caste census.
Okay, wait. Are Brahmins a minority in India?
Brahmins are the ruling class. No.
Since I am the only Muslim on the panel, Vivek ji, 10 seconds de dijiye. I am the only Muslim, so I would like nobody should do Muslims planning to me. First of all, we are not minority, we are second largest majority in this country. Ye minority ka keeda dalna band kijiye. Minority to wo hai jo micro minority Parsi bichare gayab ho gaye sab kuch. Nahi, don't compare. We are not minority, we are second largest majority. Bhai, are I am a Muslim, what are you saying? Bhai, aap maulana ho kya? Are ye kya tarika hai? Muslim is not being allowed to speak on Muslim issues. भाई विवेक श्रीवास्तव ये क्या तरीका है भाई ये क्या तरीका है इतना अत्याचार मेरे पे हो रहा है सुनिए आप मेरी बात अब साइलेंस भी दोनों विवेक अब विवेक से काम लो 10 सेकंड सुन लो कौन से वाले विवेक से पता नहीं अब 10 सेकंड और देखिए मैं केवल इतना पूछना चाहता हूं कि आपने कहा कि माइनॉरिटीज अभी आपने कहा जितनी आबादी उतना हक तो फिर उस लॉजिक के हिसाब से तो हिंदूस की आबादी ज्यादा है तो हिंदूस का पहला हक होना चाहिए ना विवेक जी एग्री करते हो नहीं एग्री करते हो अगर जितनी आबादी उतना हक है तो हिंदूज आर इन मेजोरिटी हिंदूज का पहला
हक कहिए उनकी पूरी पॉलिटिक्स उल्टी हो जाएगी
यू कैन नॉट पुट द कास्ट सिस्टम अवे व्हिच हैज बीन एक्सप्लॉइटेड
अच्छा वेरी गुड विवेक जी वेरी गुड 10 सेकंड Muslims have more caste, which is Ansari, Ghosi, Dhobi, Halalkhor, Julaha, who are not allowed by the Ashraf Samaj to come to the mosque, who are not allowed in the burial ground. Say that we want that the Muslim Jati should also be, Muslim Jati is also there. Please identify and then say that we will be against anybody who says that Islam is an egalitarian religion, which you then oppose the anti-conversion laws. Say you will stop opposing.
No. Listen to me. I'll just take 10 seconds. You are wrong. What? Because in Islam, officially, you do not have the caste system that stands for equality. Whereas in Hindu,
अरे आप practically बोलो ना.
आपने one
practically.
भगवत गीता में लिखी है intercast marriage. भगवत गीता में रोकी गई है.
विवेक श्रीवास्तव. विवेक श्रीवास्तव जी, आप उसको समझा रहे हैं जो रोज इस difference को जीता है. आप उसको theory समझा रहे हैं. मुझे नहीं समझ में आ रहा ये विवेक कहां से आ रहा बट आई वांट टू कम बैक टू द मोट पॉइंट एंड आई वांट टू आस्क रोहित अग्रवाल इज द इंडिया अलायंस आफ्टर द डेबिकल इन हरियाणा लुकिंग फॉर अ नैरेटिव बिकॉज देयर पीडीए नैरेटिव वाज पंक्चर्ड Haryana did not deliver a victory. Now they want to resurrect it because they are totally spooked that if the Hindu consolidation happens the way it did in Haryana, it happens in Maharashtra and Jharkhand, then once again their PDA formula may not work. Does it boil down simply to that? Is the 9-seat election in Uttar Pradesh also something that will determine literally the pecking order in the India alliance, which is why you're seeing such a tough struggle for seat distribution both in UP and Maharashtra? Because A, they have to fight with the BJP, and B, within the India bloc, they have to fight for their own existence and their own caste system.
Actually, Navika ji, the fact is, teen nishane pe lagaya. Isiliye pura vipaksh bilbila raha hai. The people the people who were trying to divide the country in the name of PDA, today they have a problem with बटेंगे तो कटेंगे. भाई बटेंगे तो कटेंगे का नरेटिव तो यही है ना कि जुड़ के रहो, और जुड़ के रहो अगर हम बोल रहे हैं तो आपको प्रॉब्लम क्या है? आपने तो 1947 में कंट्री को धर्म के नाम पे बांटा था, आप आज जाति के नाम पे बांटना चाहते हो. अबू आजमी कहते हैं किसकी माँ ने दूध पिलाया है? अबू आजमी जी, माँ चाहे मुसलमान की हो चाहे हिंदू की हो, माँ तो माँ होती है, माँ को क्यों खींचते हो बीच में? अगर आपको ये देखना है कि किसमें ताकत ज्यादा है तो आपको तो अपने मौलानाओं से कहना चाहिए ना, जो इस तरीके का नैरेटिव फैलाने का, नफरत फैलाने का काम कर रहे हैं देश के अंदर, जो आज नफरत देश के अंदर इस चरम सीमा पे लेके आए हैं कि वो जाति के नाम पे, धर्म के नाम पे वोट मांग रहे हैं, अपनी राजनीतिक जमीन को ढूंढने का काम कर रहे हैं, आज उनके ऊपर आपकी आपका मुंह नहीं खुलता है. परंतु आपका मुंह किसके ऊपर खुल रहा है? जहां पे जोड़ने की बात हो रही है. एंड व्हाट अबाउट दिस विवेक जी, विवेक जी, इन वायनाड फॉर हुम यू आर आस्किंग फॉर अ वोट? फॉर प्रियंका गांधी और फॉर योर CPI कैंडिडेट? लाइक व्हाट आर यू थिंकिंग? द पब्लिक इज फूल that in Wayanad you are contesting an election against Priyanka Gandhi, and here on television you are defending the Congress. See, this is the real face of India Gadbandhan, which is almost came to an end when in Uttar Pradesh Congress was shown their face by Samajwadi Party, that you don't have even capacity to fight even in a single seat in Uttar Pradesh by election. And the same what Congress is trying to do with Samajwadi Party in Maharashtra election, that they are not ready to take them to their boat.
Well this said. Is what well said, Rohit Agarwal. Hands going up. Hands going up. Sanjay Jha first.
Yeah. Navika, I was very amused when the gentleman mentioned, clearly he's not a very
strong... mentioned the gentleman because there are six gentlemen on the show, well, except
well, Mr.
me.
Mr. Agarwal, when he talked about India's history, he doesn't even know how India was partitioned. I mean, jis party ke aapke jo guru log hain, wo to angrezo ke saath the. Aap log to itne darpok aur kayar the ki aapne Bharat ke sangram mein, azadi ke ladai mein aap logon ne ka koi yogdan hi nahi hai. Zero hai aapka yogdan.
Kaun angrezo ke saath tha aur kaun angrezo ko bhaga raha tha? Ek minute,
aapko beech mein maine nahi toka tha Agarwal ji, zara bolne dijiye.
Aur aap to kam se kam mat boliye. आप तो कम से कम मत बोलिए ना सर,
सुनिए ना,
जो कि अंग्रेजों को देश के अंदर स्थापित करने का काम कर रहा था, जो कि
जरा एक
धर्म के नाम पे देश को बांटने का काम कर रहा था, और आज ये सच्चाई अगर जनता के सामने आ रही है तो आपको प्रॉब्लम हो रही है.
ओके, वन एट अ टाइम. संजय झा, कंप्लीट योर पॉइंट.
या रोहित जी, इन महाराष्ट्र वेयर आई लिव, रोहित जी, आपके जो भूतपूर्व मुख्यमंत्री है देवेंद्र फडणवीस जी, उन्होंने यहाँ पर एक फैलाया एक और एक अफवाह, वोट जिहाद हो रहा है यहाँ पर. मुसलमान भाई भाजपा के लिए वोट नहीं कर रहे हैं, और इंडियन एक्सप्रेस ने उनके झूठ का पूरा पर्दाफाश और भंडाफोड़ किया है. आप लोग कितना सांप्रदायिक राजनीति कीजिएगा.
आप सडनली वोट जिहाद इज सो ऑब्जेक्शनेबल. संजय झा, व्हाई डिडंट यू ऑब्जेक्ट टू इट व्हेन विवेक साइलेसिस पार्टी and his colleague said it in the presence of your leader Mr. Salman Khurshid? I didn't see you complaining one little bit, objecting.
I will answer that.
So that's the hypocrisy. When Akhilesh Yadav says PDA na batega na katega, it's secular. When Samajwadi Party leader says vote jihad ho raha hai, hame vote jihad karna padega, it's secular. But if Devendra Fadnavis says or Yogi Adityanath says, शहजाद पूनावाला, इट्स सो कम्युनल, सो कम्युनल.
मरियम आलम का बयान, महबूब अली का बयान, ये सिलेक्टिवली हियर नहीं करना है. और जब ये बताया जाए कि ये हो रहा है तो वो तो गुनहगार है. दूसरी बात, अभी संजय झा ने कहा कि आरएसएस का या हमारे संघ परिवार का कोई योगदान नहीं था आजादी के आंदोलन में. देवीपद चौधरी एंड जगतपति कुमार, दे टुक द बुलेट्स ऑन द चेस्ट इन द 1942 आंदोलन. सोनिया गांधी का परिवार जो था, माइनो परिवार, वो कौन सी लड़ाई लड़ रहा था 42 में, बताइए जरा हमको.
कि जब गांधी जी का
गांधी जी नहीं, गांधी जी आपके परिवार से नहीं है सोनिया जी के, अरे बख्श दो भाई, गांधी जी का, गांधी जी ऑल्सो गॉट असैसिनेटेड इन 48, नॉट ड्यूरिंग द इंडिपेंडेंस स्ट्रगल। आई एम आस्किंग विच मेंबर ऑफ सोनिया माइनो फैमिली टुक द बुलेट, यू टेल मी, हाउ वाज दिस पॉइंट रिलेवेंट टू टुडेज़ डेट?
देयर यू आर गेटिंग डाउन इनटू यू नो स्लाइटली कॉम्प्लिकेटेड टेरिटरी।
माय ग्रैंडफादर वाज नॉट इन कांग्रेस, सो दैट मींस ही डिड नॉट फाइट फॉर इंडिपेंडेंस, ही इज इंसल्ट my grandfather. I don't know what Sanjay Das grandfather was doing, but my grandfather was
certainly fighting. पंडित नेहरू एंड ऑल वर इन्वॉल्व, मोतीलाल नेहरू,
सोनिया गांधी का फैमिली थोड़ी इन्वॉल्व था, तो सोनिया गांधी किस लिहाज से आ
सकता है? सोनिया गांधी इज पार्ट ऑफ द फैमिली, कम ऑन नाउ, यू विल से दैट माय हस्बैंड्स फैमिली इज नॉट माय फैमिली, लेट्स नॉट गो देयर, दैट्स अ सेपरेट डिबेट। आई वांट टू आस्क यू विवेक साइलस, वोट जिहाद अगर आपकी लीडर बोले, मोहतरमा ने स्टेज पे बोला था ना, और सलमान खुर्शीद जी बैठे थे ना वहां, तब ठीक था। अखिलेश जी कहे बीडीए ना बटेगा ना कटेगा, वो सेक्युलर है, योगी जी कहे कम्युनल हो गया।
देखिए नाविका जी, वोट जिहाद पे हमारी आपसे उस समय भी डिबेट हुई थी, और मैंने कहा था कि जहां तक समाजवादी पार्टी का ख्याल है या मेरा ख्याल है, हमने कहा ये बात जो स्टेटमेंट है वो गलत है। अभी आनंद रंगनाथ,
क्या एक्शन लिया आपने?
आनंद
क्या एक्शन लिया,
मुझे खत्म कर लेने दे। आनंद रंगनाथन जी ने कहा कि जो इंडिया अलायंस है वो अपीजमेंट की बुलेट ट्रेन चला रहा है, तो आपने कर्नाटक का एग्जाम्पल भी दिया आनंद जी, लेकिन कर्नाटक में तो आदरणीय प्रधानमंत्री बजरंग बली को भी लेकर आए थे, बंगाल चले जाइए तो बांग्लादेश पहुंच गए थे जब कोविड का पीक टाइम था, मतुआ कम्युनिटी को प्लीज करने के लिए वहां मतुआ मंदिर में जाके उन्होंने जाके मत्था भी टेक दिया था। और इस तरह के स्टेटमेंट 80-20 ईद दिवाली शमशान कब्रिस्तान कपड़ों से पहला पहचान लेते हैं, ये इसका क्या मतलब है? ये अपीजमेंट पॉलिटिक्स नहीं है तो क्या हुआ? क्या है बहराइच में भी? क्या हुआ? दो घंटे के लिए आपने पुलिस हटा ली थी कि जितना मर्जी दंगा करो कुछ नहीं होगा। भारतीय जनता पार्टी के एमएलए ने इसकी शिकायत की, एफआईआर कराया नगर अध्यक्ष विकास श्रीवास्तव के ऊपर कि वो इन्वॉल्व था, और भारतीय जनता पार्टी इस तरह की बात करती। चुनाव जीतने के लिए भारतीय जनता पार्टी ने बहराइच में दंगे कराए, ये जग जाहिर हो चुका है। और रोहित अग्रवाल पे तो मैं कुछ कहूंगा, अच्छे दोस्त हैं, दया आती है, सिंबल इनका है, और शहजाद पूना वाले भारतीय जनता पार्टी ने अपना कैंडिडेट लड़ाया, तो आपका तो कैंडिडेट भी नहीं लड़ रहा है रोहित अग्रवाल जी, तो आप शांत
रहे। आप कौन सा लड़वा रहे हो कांग्रेस का?
कांग्रेस के दो कैंडिडेट लड़ रहे हैं हमारे सिंबल पे, तो हम तो खुलेआम कह रहे हैं
वाह वाह,
दो कैंडिडेट कांग्रेस के लड़ रहे हैं समाजवादी पार्टी के सिंबल।
देखिए पहले तो जिनके शासनकाल में 700 दंगे हुए हो, मुजफ्फरनगर का दंगा, 2013 का दंगा, और उसके अलावा बहुत सारे दंगे, तो मुझे लगता है, और जो बहराइच में हुआ, इससे प्लीज मैंने आपके बीच विवेक जी मैंने आपके बीच में नहीं बोला फिर मैं भी डिस्टर्ब कर रहा हूं, विवेक जी मैंने आपके बीच में नहीं बोला। अब देखिए कितनी चालाकी से विवेक ने राम गोपाल मिश्र, जिसको बिना कोई कारण के मार दिया गया, उसको दंगा बता दिया, मतलब कि दो तरफ से हुआ। मरा कौन? राम गोपाल मिश्र। क्यों? क्योंकि तथाकथित रूप से झंडा उतारा गया, या झंडा उतारा तो झंडे को उतारने की सजा जो है मौत की होगी, राम गोपाल मिश्र नाम होगा, यह जस्टिफाई करने के लिए उसको दंगा बोल रहे हैं। एक तरफा हमला था वो राम गोपाल मिश्र पर, उसको किस प्रकार से खींचा गया, और आप राम गोपाल मिश्रा की डेथ को जायज ठहरा रहे हैं? ये दंगा बचाओ, ये है हत्यारा बचाओ आंदोलन।
अतुल गुप्ता को इंसाफ दिया, कासगंज वाले को सिर्फ आप लोग वादे करते हैं, काम कुछ नहीं करते हैं।
अच्छा मुझे बताइए, वन मिनट आई कम बैक टू द होल पॉइंट दैट वी स्टार्टेड द डिबेट विद एंड आनंद रंगनाथन, इज इट वंस अगेन द वॉर ऑफ नैरेटिव्स? द लोकसभा इलेक्शन नैरेटिव वर्क्ड फॉर the India Alliance, so they did Jati Janganna in the Haryana elections, it did not work for them at all. Is that why they are spooked by this katenge batenge to katenge that has set the track for elections both in UP and in Maharashtra?
No doubt about it, Navika, but I again set the context for this statement, now iconic statement. It was in the context of what is happening in Bangladesh and what is happening to the Hindus in Bangladesh. Beral, there is a living example right in front of our eyes. The Hindus that escaped 1971 genocide from Bangladesh, settled in a place called Mari Jhapi, wo bat gaye the, sare Dalit the, 10,500 Dalit were massacred by the CPIM. In fact, there is a book called Blood Island. Please read that by Deep Haldar. And now these are the same communists who are accusing others for bartering. दे मर्सीलेसली मैसेकर 10,000 दलित इन ब्रॉड डे लाइट द CPIM and nobody knows about it because they are the ones who are in charge of setting out what people should
well,
do what should not.
Well, but well, silence well, the question tonight is just this. Does the statement become communal because the BJP says the same words if used by parties in the India Alliance? Are they having a copyright on secularism so they can say it without impunity? Is this a new war of narratives that's taking place for the upcoming elections in both Maharashtra, Jharkhand and the bipoles in Uttar Pradesh? Well, it's all happening right here on battlefield politics in these states. For now, thank you very much to all my panelists for joining me on debate number one.